We're about 15 miles from the Atlantic coast in the northeast corner of Florida. Welcome to Everbank Stadium here in Jacksonville. Stage is set. Ball is on the tee. And off we go on EA Sports. And he's brought down right at the 25-yard line. First and 10. Here's Lawrence to throw right away. A pass complete to the tight end, Evan Engram.
And this is where the versatility of the tight end position really starts coming into play. Not only do they have to line up with their hand on the ground, but they can occasionally split out in the slot. And man, they're too fast for linebackers, and a lot of times, they're too big for defensive backs.
Lawrence now on second down. The ball deflected at least a couple of times, but it'll fall to the ground. It's incomplete. Third down, three to go. Working out of the gun, it's Lawrence. That one on target with Kirk. They've got it. They get 10 yards on the hook up there. That's good for a Jaguar. First down. From the shotgun, it's Lawrence. And they'll get about four here as he is taken down. Here's a second and six. First carry for the Auburn alum, Tank Bigsby. It's a short pickup, taking this to the 49. Amani Hooker there on the tackle. Now, following the run, one of the offensive linemen leading the way is a bit shaken up. So as they look at the injured player, we'll take a timeout. Here's third and two. They'll try and run for the first with ETN. And that call will not get it done. The defense ready, stopping him behind the line of scrimmage. And it sets up fourth down.
The idea here for this offense is you're not really thinking necessarily touchdown. You're thinking first down. Let's get a fresh set of downs here and reset. But in this case, they suffer a loss, and it brings up fourth down.
And no chance of a run back here. This one's going to sail out of bounds. Break the huddle. Coming up now for first and 10. First carry for the man from Memphis, Tony Pollard. And he'll manage to get this ahead for a pickup of five. Again, it's Pollard. And this defense up to the task there. Gain of just two, and it's third down. They'll try and run for the first down with Pollard. Pollard, first down, and more. Oh, what a run. Down inside the 30-yard line.
There's a combination of footwork and vision. His ability to kind of weave through traffic and understand where the holes were It's a really nice job working through some bodies and picking up a big game.
On play action, he'll set up to throw. Here's a shot toward the end zone. Calvin Ridley was the intended receiver, and it'll bring up second down.
So, of course, you prefer to connect on that throw, but think about it like this, Mike. The more they continue to test this defense downfield, the more it's going to open up some of those shorter passes underneath.
Now, faking the give. And he got rid of that one quickly before the receiver even knew what was going on. That's incomplete. Tyler Boyd was the intended target, and it's going to be third down.
As a pass rusher, you don't always need to record a sack to make your presence felt. Creating pressure, move the quarterback, affect his timing. Those are all different ways to take pressure off your coverage unit.
It is caught. It is Westbrook-Ikhine. And a good job here defensively. They did not let him get away. He's well short of the first down marker. And Nick Folk will try it for Tennessee. His kick is perfect. And the Titans will take a 3-0 lead. The kickoff team is out on the field, and we're back to it as the kick's away. On the return, it's Parker Washington. He'll work his way across the 25-yard line. The Jags offense ready to see the football for the second time. This one has been tight so far. A field goal separating the two sides as this drive kicks off with first and 10. He'll give it to ETN to start this drive. Trying to find some place to go, but nothing developing. Tackled behind the line. It's a loss of one.
Great job by the defense here, quickly realizing that this was going to be a draw. They're not caught off guard, thinking that they're defending the pass. They're able to not only get in there for a stop, but they're able to take him down in the backfield for a loss.
In the pistol, here's Lawrence. There's a short one taken by Ingram.
Great timing and anticipation. The second the tight end's head turned around, the quarterback put the ball on him, and now it's, hey, let's see who wants to tackle this big guy and bring him to the ground.
Third and a yard. They put Strange in motion. Off the play fake. Here's Lawrence. This is going to be incomplete. That is great work there, making things difficult defensively. It'll set up a fourth down.
And that's exactly how you teach it. They want these defenders to time the hit, that right when the ball gets there, you separate the receiver from the ball. And those are the ones on offense, man. You just have to make that catch, Mike. I know it's easier said than done, but you know the hit's coming. You've got to squeeze that thing, brace for impact, and make that play for your offense.
The Titans offense ready to see what they can do on their second possession. They had the field goal on the opening drive to take the early lead. See if they can improve on it here. 3-0 is our score, and it's first and 10. On the RPO, a pass taken by Ridley. And he's brought down after a gain of 6 on first down.
We hear the term RPO so often, Mike, and it continues to kind of trickle its way into the NFL. But remember, it's a lot different in the NFL than it is in the college game, where it's a lot more prevalent. The lineman cannot go downfield, so that quarterback has to make a lot of really fast snapshot decisions, or else it's going to lead to a penalty or him holding on to the ball too long. So It's something that teams want to implement, but maybe not quite to the level that we see in the college game.
Line of scrimmage is the 31 as they line up first and 10. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. He'll let it go deep left sideline. And that is incomplete, but a penalty flag is down. Let's see who they got. Set to go now on first and 10. Now Rudolph. That caught Tony Pollard. And they'll get about half of what they needed. It's a pickup of 5 and sets up second and 5. Rudolph looking to throw. Looking middle, and he's got Ridley. And they'll take this down inside the 35. Following the completion, we'll get a stoppage here for an injured player. Athletic training staff looking at him, so we'll step aside. Throwing, Rudolph. He'll get this one to his safety valve. Complete. That's a gain of 11. And they'll move the chains with another first down.
It's like a textbook, methodical, efficient NFL drive. 4 for 4 throwing the ball, mixing in some run. You're just marching the ball downfield at your will. And they get a fresh set of downs now to see if they can convert this nice drive into some points.
Work in the middle of the field, but that is incomplete.
At this level, you just would expect a little bit better execution and accuracy on those intermediate throws. I think he had an opportunity there for a nice pickup. Off target, off rhythm, and ends up getting away from him.
The motion man is Board. Off play action. He'll set up to throw. That's going to be intercepted in the end zone. That's the safety, Andre Cisco. They'll start this one with a 3 tight end look. On first down, Lawrence. He's got the tight end, Luke Farrell. And he's brought down after a gain of 6 on first down. They'll come up now for second down and 4. Here's Lawrence to throw. To the right side, he's got Ingram, the tight end. And they'll whistle him down, but not before he picks up a first down after a gain of 7.
Nothing a quarterback loves more, Mike, than being able to pick up a first down without being forced to push the ball downfield and force it past the line to gain. He settles for the underneath check down. He's confident that his receiver is going to pick up the rest after the catch.
And a good job following his blockers. A gain of 7. It'll be second down. Lawrence will give it to Bigsby. And he tries to get back to the line of scrimmage, but will not happen here. I think he's going to lose a yard.
You have to wonder if next time, does the play caller give his quarterback some options to check out of this play? It was clear before the ball was snapped. This was not a great look for that play call, and you can see the end result.
Lawrence from the gun here on third down. That's caught left side. It's complete. And he is out of bounds, but not until he's inside the 40-yard line. They get 25 on that connection. First down, Jacksonville. Lawrence gives this one to ETN. And he'll manage to pick up about four. Amani Hooker there on the tackle. Second down, Lawrence. That's over the middle, but it's incomplete. Gabe Davis, the intended receiver, and it'll be third down.
Based on the routes downfield, it looked like the protection was designed to give the quarterback a little bit more time to wait for things to uncover downfield. So give credit up front to the defensive line. Immediate pressure early speeds up the quarterback's clock. He's got no choice than to get rid of it, probably a little bit earlier than he would have preferred.
And he's going to be taken down short of the marker, and that is going to set up an interesting fourth down decision.
When you're willing to throw the ball short of the sticks on third down, you know what that tells me, Mike? The decision to go for it on fourth down has already been made. If you're able to pick it up with yards after the catch, great. But if not, it's a fourth and short, and you give yourself a realistic shot of converting on this fourth down.
It's a pickup of 12 as they wind up converting on fourth down.
Well, this is the advantage to having a really effective passing game, Mike, as the defense now tries to adjust to stopping you through the air. It's a lot easier to mix it up and run the ball. There's a lot less defenders in there trying to stop you.
The tight end, Ingram, is on the move. A first down throw for Lawrence. That's into the hands of Travis Etienne. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play in this opening quarter. This drive has been methodical, but will they turn it into 6 points? It is first and goal. And this throw out of the back of the end zone. It's incomplete. They'll try it again from the two. Second and goal. In motion comes Thomas. Now second down throw for Lawrence. That's to the end zone, but they can't connect. It's incomplete. Evan Ingram, the intended target. And now it's third and goal.
Goes without saying, Mike, you have to be smart with the ball, especially down here in the red zone. You're already in scoring position. And I understand they're trying to come away with a touchdown, but at the very least, come away with three. Worst case scenario is you turn the ball over.
And that big offensive line, clearing space. He's in. Travis Etienne, touchdown Jacksonville. So on third and goal, they run it in. Sometimes, Greg, that's four down territory. They didn't need to do it on fourth down, taking care of it on the third down for the touchdown.
Yeah, and when you find yourself down here this close, Mike, you have to finish these drives off. I'm with you. I think he was going to give his back two shots there to punch it in, but he only needed one.
Both teams ready to go once more as the kick's away. This taken in at the 8-yard line. And it'll be brought down past the 25. Decent field position to start this drive. The Titans offense getting their final instructions before heading back onto the field. They trail by 4. Touchdown gives them the lead. Drive begins with 1st and 10. Back to throw is Rudolph. And that ball out of reach toward the sideline. It'll be an incompletion.
Well, it's pretty clear the main reason why they find themselves trailing in this game, Mike, has really just been the inefficiency of this offense and primarily out of the quarterback position. I mean, to complete less than half of your pass attempts, it just makes it very hard to compete at a high level consistently in the NFL. And if they want to find themselves having any chance of getting back into this game and winning this one, he's going to have to get a lot better with the ball. Some defensive ends specialize in getting after the quarterback. Some defensive ends specialize in run game. This guy can really make an impact on both, as we saw here for that tackle for loss.
To throw is Rudolph. And on 3rd down, that ball incomplete.
And barring an aggressive decision here on 4th down, it just seemed like a really wasted possession to go 3 and out. Not able to pick up a single 1st down. Not only do you not able to gain any field position advantage, it really takes a lot of the wind out of your sails as you find yourself jogging off the field and the punt team coming on.
On the return, here's Washington. Oh, looks like he may have had a seam for a moment, but he's taken down after a solid return. The Jaguars offense ready to see what they can do with this next possession. The lead sits at 4, so they'll try to add on to that. This drive begins with 1st and 10. To throw is Lawrence. They'll be forced to just throw that one away. It's incomplete. We'll try again. It's 2nd and 10. In motion comes Thomas. Lawrence now on 2nd down. That's caught left side by Ingram. And he's taken down inside the opponent's 35.
This defense just gets punched in the mouth on that one, Mike, and it just seemed from up here that not everyone on defense was on the same page, and the offense was able to take advantage of it. The defense has to clean things up here in a hurry, because if they don't, they could be in for a long day.
Now Lawrence on the bootleg. Open man is Davis. And he's brought down after a gain of 6 on 1st down. They'll work now on 2nd and 4. On the handoff, it's Etienne. And that one shut down pretty quickly. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage. Nothing more.
All the qualities that make a good safety are seen on display on this play. Speed, pursuit, and then the intensity and the strength at the point of contact for the tackle to keep this ball carrier to no gain. That is a complete safety play.
That's over the middle and intercepted. Picked off by Jerome Baker. And the Titans are going to have it. They'll take over at their own 24-yard line. Westbrook Akine motioning here. They'll give it to Pollard to start this drive. Nice gain on 1st down, but the penalty flags come in. And the question now, will the play stand? That coming up.
To identify zone they were playing here, the key is find open space and stay in it. He did a nice job here because that was not a big hole. Quarterback had to put a little extra on. They were able to completion.
This into the hands, Ridley complete. Is out of bounds on the other side of midfield. 4 tennis and 30 yards. Some to the lot. They'll look to end.
And get it.
And he's going to down at about the 30.
Mike, you've heard me say 1,000 times, the easiest down to throw the ball in the NFL is first down. I hate when teams wait till later in the possession to throw the ball. So early first down completion, you're on the plus side of the field. Now you're thinking strike, touchdown, field goal. But either way, I'm coming away with points.
A very quick throw there, but not on the same page with his target. That's incomplete.
One of those plays where you like the idea, you just don't like the execution. I didn't feel the quarterback was overly comfortable in the pocket. Footwork, a little bit sloppy. All of a sudden now the pass is a little less accurate and an opportunity for a big shot. You end up falling short.
They'll look to throw again. No chance at all. He'll go down.
Just another example of poor decision making. I mean, making a bad play even worse. There's nothing there on second down. Just throw the ball into the stands and move on to third. Now you take that sack, and it's going to take a miracle to stay on the field.
Throwing now on third and long. They'll be forced to just throw that one away. It's incomplete.
So defensively, there's always the initial pass coverage plan. And then when that breaks down and the quarterback goes into scramble mode, how fast can you then move on to the second phase and what they call plaster, meaning find the nearest receiver and almost play a man-to-man. And it's exactly what they did here. And there was nowhere for the ball to go, and he's forced to just throw it away.
Folks, kick is good. And the Titans are back within one. It's 7-6. The kickoff team is out on the field, and we're back to it as the kick's away. Washington now to return it. And this will work out quite well. He'll get it all the way out to the 30-yard line. Here comes the Jacksonville offense now, heading back onto the field. They'll begin with first and 10. The drive begins with a carry from Etienne. And some good running there. He'll fall forward for about 7. Here's 2nd and 3 to go. Once again, it's Etienne. And he'll get back maybe to the line of scrimmage, but probably going to be a loss of a yard here.
When you can get this level of run support out of your secondary, Mike, man, what an advantage for any defense. This defensive back clearly reads run, gets off his block, and he's able to take down the back for a loss of yards.
On third down, here's Etienne. And he's going to be taken down here. Looks like a pretty good spot, though. Yes, he's got it. That's a first down. The tight end, Ingram, is on the move. They'll go back to Etienne on first down. Midfield to the 45, and he'll be out of bounds, but not before he gets inside the 35-yard line. A pickup there of 25 yards. That's good for a Jaguar first down. On 1st and 10, it's Bigsby. Here's 2nd and 6. Now Etienne. And he's fighting to try to get back to the line of scrimmage, but will not do it. This is going to be a loss of a yard.
It was clear this offseason this was an area of emphasis. They wanted to continue to fortify the interior of this defensive line, and with this young player, they think they've got themselves a good one.
They need the 24-yard line as they come up for third down. From the shotgun, it's Lawrence. Taking off, he'll try to get there.
Great reaction by the defense. At first, like there was enough room out there for the quarterback to pick this one up himself, but they were able to rally to the ball, and I think the officials are going to mark him just short.
So, fourth down, and on comes the rookie, Cam Little, for this Jaguar field goal. This one from 41 yards out. Little's kick is good, and the Jaguars extend their lead to 10-6. Both teams ready to go once more as the kick's away. On the return, here's Tajay Spears. And he'll be brought down just beyond the 25-yard line. Out comes the Tennessee offense. They get set to see what they can do. They'll start it here with a first and 10. Rudolph looking to throw. He'll look for Pollard out of the backfield. That's a gain of 19 and a very quick first down.
We see this week in and week out, Mike, these running backs in today's game, they really have the skill set of a wide receiver. So if you're going to guard him one-on-one and you know the offense is going to use him in the passing game, you better have that guy. You better have that matchup guy that you're confident to put on him and say, okay, you're going to go out there in space and defend a receiver like this. And after plays like that, I'm not sure how much more man coverage they can afford to play.
Second down and 8. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Now, a deep ball here for Ridley. That ball incomplete. Got the hands in there to break it up. Could have been a big gainer. Instead, it sets up a third down.
You know, it's hard to speculate, Mike. We sit up here and we try to just interpret and assume what's going on in the minds of the players and the minds of the coaches, but they seem to me to be a little bit rattled. All these negative plays have really started to pile up in the first half. He's got to settle down, have some more efficiency on these early downs, and get his offense into some sort of rhythm. Certainly not one of his better throws, but what I've loved out of this quarterback today, Mike, was just how aggressive he's remained throughout the entire course of the game. Continue to push the ball downfield. Even if it falls incomplete, it opens up everything else in this passing game, and they've had their way so far today.
And no return forthcoming. It's a touchback and will come out to the 20-yard line. The Jaguars offense ready to get back at it. They'll see if they can put something together here, beginning with first and 10. Three tight ends in the game to start the drive. Lawrence now to throw on first down. And a good effort there defensively. It's knocked away and incomplete.
This is teach tape for man defense, Mike. I mean, he's not looking back at the quarterback at all. He is in the hip pocket of his receiver. He's staying in phase and in rhythm. And then he knows when the wide receiver's hands go up, attack the ball. And that's about as good as it gets.
Working out of the gun, it's Lawrence. And they'll get about 8 out of that one, but still a little work to do now on third down.
The drag route is such a good way to get the ball early into the hands of your tight end and take some pressure off the quarterback and give him an easy completion. The size and the athleticism allows them to try to pick up more yards, but do it after the catch.
Now a handoff, ETN, and he's going to be taken down as we hit the 2-minute warning here in this first half. On first down, Lawrence. Open man downfield, that's Ingram. That'll be taken down, but it takes them across midfield down to the 40-yard line.
So if you're going to have time to allow your big tight end to start on one side of the field and run a crossing route all the way to the other, your big guys up front better hold up in protection. That's exactly what they were able to do here. Gave the quarterback the confidence of staying with them the entire way through, delivering that ball on the far side of the field, and leads to a nice pickup.
Second and a yard. Lawrence now. He keeps it himself. Trevor avoids the hit, takes a slide, but also picks up a first down.
I love this call, Mike. Second down and short. One of the best downs in football to take a shot. Give credit to the defense. They were ready for it. But a nice job by the quarterback, realizing there's nothing downfield. Take off, turn into a runner, pick up the first down.
They'll come up here, first and 10. Now here's Lawrence. Now a screen set up for ETN. And they'll get about half of what they needed. It's a pickup of 5 and sets up second and 5. Now, whistles here. Looks like one of the defenders got a head start. Here's Lawrence. And that is caught in the end zone. He's in. Christian Kirk. Touchdown, Jaguars.
Just a really nice job, Mike, especially just staying poised. Pressure situation. You know how important it is to steal some points before the half. But everybody's in control. Everybody understood the situation and the clock. And they're able to finish that half in style with that late touchdown.
Closing seconds of this first half, and this kickoff is away. This one is fielded in the end zone, but he decides not to bring it out, so they'll take over at the 30-yard line. The Titans offense going to get it one final time in this first half. The deficit is double digits, so work to do as they begin this drive with first and 10. Rudolph. Now a screen. Here's Pollard. And he's close to a first down. It's a gain of 9. Nice pitch and catch on first down. The Titans offense going to get it one last time here late in the opening half. A good spot here. Second and a yard. Throwing, Rudolph. going to go down. He could not get rid of it. And that's going to bring an end to this first half. Pretty interesting first half. We'll see if any strategy changes for the next 30 minutes or more as this second half gets underway. Nice job by the return team as he takes it across the 30-yard line. The visitors' offense going to have a first crack at it as we begin this third quarter. They'll start out first down and 10. The drive starts. It's a carry by Pollard. And he'll manage to get to the 33. Devin Lloyd, the linebacker, there to stop him. Here's a second and 9. He'll drop to throw. He's going to get it to Okonkwo. And they'll hold him to a gain of just a couple and sets up third down. Back to throw is Rudolph. He's gonna let this one go deep. That's caught! And he will score! Nick Westbrook-Ikhine, touchdown Tennessee.
This is when you're very fortunate as an offensive play caller, Mike, that you not only have the speed on the outside, but you got the big arm behind center, because it doesn't get real fancy. If you can hold up in the protection, you're saying run as fast and as far as you can. I'm gonna throw it as far as I can, and when you connect, it is a thing of beauty, and in this case, it results in a touchdown. Pretty evident that they felt the weakness of this rush defense was on the perimeter. A simple toss play gets the back out there so fast, they secure the edge, and it just becomes a foot race, and he walks in for an easy 2 points.
The kickoff team is out on the field, and we're back to it as the kick's away. Washington now to return it. And their drive will begin at the 30-yard line. The Jaguars' offense ready for their first possession of this second half. They lead by a field goal as they go to work with a first and 10. Lawrence going to keep this himself. And he'll get this forward to about the 33.
Nice job by the defense. They had that one well read from the beginning, Mike. Someone's responsible for the running back, but the key here was the defender responsible for the quarterback. Stays with him, keeps him to a short game.
Second and 7. In motion comes Thomas. Second down, Lawrence. Catch made right side by Thomas. And he's taken down inside the opponent's 35.
It's not a coincidence, Mike, that the best offenses in the NFL are all excellent at yards after the catch. It's a combination of a few things. A highly accurate quarterback and the ability of the scheme to get open players in open space. Once you do that, the rest is up to them.
On the give, it's ETN. He'll take this down inside the 30. Kenneth Murray, the linebacker, there on the stop. They face second down and 7. Off the play fake. Here's Lawrence. That's complete to ETN. Well, he's brought down. That pass is going to pick up 4 and bring up third down.
Bold decision there by this quarterback to attack a guy who's already made you pay for challenging him earlier today. He trusted his guy to not only win, but to defeat man coverage, and I think he got away with one there.
They'll try and run for the first with Etienne.
Nothing real fancy about this call here, Mike, right? In this third and short, just get the ball to your running back, make sure he has enough space to pick up the first down, and they're able to convert.
They're at the 17-yard line now for first and 10. Davis heading in motion. And that one knocked away. It's incomplete. Brian Thomas, the intended receiver. And it'll be second down.
In what's clearly become a passing league, Mike, if you're not actively rushing the passer, you have to be able to hold up in coverage, and that's especially true at the linebacker position. Great job here getting in those passing lanes and being able to break up that ball.
That's caught over the middle by Thomas. And the Jaguars are going to have a first and goal coming up. They try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
Nice play here by Thomas. And I think the biggest thing that he does, Mike, is his ability to get vertical, track the ball, and then go up and compete at the highest point. And I can tell you, when quarterbacks can throw that ball anywhere on the field and just feel like their guy is going to come down with it, they don't have to be necessarily as accurate. They don't have to necessarily always be perfect. The wide receiver allows a much larger margin for error, and it's a big reason why he led college football last year in touchdowns.
Here now, second down and goal. To throw is Lawrence. That's to the end zone, but it's incomplete.
There was tight coverage all across the field. I think the quarterback thought he had the arm strength to fit this one into a pretty small window, but the defense wasn't having it. They were all over it, and I think the quarterback actually got away with one there.
The ball inches from the goal line, third and goal. They put Strange in motion. They'll try and run with Etienne, and he will dive into the end zone. Travis Etienne, touchdown Jacksonville. That is second touchdown of the afternoon. Little on now for the extra point. His kick is good, and the Jaguars go up by 10. 24-14 is their lead. Both teams ready to go once more as the kick's away. This returnable from the 4. And he is stopped at the 25. The drive will begin there. The visitors' offense ready to come back out for this next possession. The deficit is 10, 24-14. So work to do as they come up for first and 10. Rudolph. A throw over the middle and they can't connect. It's incomplete.
Anytime you see a receiver at this level miss a ball that easy, it's just concentration. They just take it for granted. All of a sudden they're thinking about what their next move is or what they're going to do after the catch. And instead of just focusing on first things first, secure the catch, put the ball away, then become a runner.
Now, faking the give. And he got rid of that one quickly before the receiver even knew what was going on. That's incomplete.
Pretty clear approach here, Mike. You're just trying to take advantage of the size of your tight end versus a smaller defender, and you're just saying box him out and go up for an offensive rebound and get the ball at its highest point. In this case, it falls incomplete, but if they continue to get that matchup, this quarterback's not going to shy away from giving his big tight end a shot.
caught. It's Westbrook-Ikhine. And they will bring him down on the other side of midfield.
I really like the rhythm that this offense has found. I mean, that third down, that wasn't a layup by any means, but they made it look easy. Everybody was exactly where they needed to be. The quarterback did a nice job working through his progression, saying, okay, I understand this is zone defense. I understand where the limitations of the coverage are. I'm going to get to that spot on the field as fast as I can, deliver the ball, pick up the first down.
And he's not going to get too far, tackled after a gain of just a yard. Here's second and 9. To throw is Rudolph. Connecting with his tight end, Okonkwo. Well, he's brought down. That pass is going to pick up 4 and bring up third down. Here's Rudolph. He's got his man. That's Boyd. And he's going to have the first down. So they convert on third down with a pickup of 9.
Really nice timing on that slant route. You can tell the quarterback and the wide receiver are completely on the same page. And when executed at that level, it's virtually impossible to stop.
They'll run the toss. Here's Pollard. And a good run there. Going to get him 5 yards. They'll break the huddle. It's 2nd and 5. Rudolph looking to throw. Complete Ridley on the reception. And it'll be a short pickup. That's not enough for the first down. They have converted twice on third down on this drive, and they need a yard here with 3rd and 1. That is intercepted. That's the safety, Andre Sisco. And the Jaguars are going to get the football here at their own 38-yard line. ETN now on 1st and 10. Not much to speak of on that one. Maybe a gain of a yard. It's 2nd down. From the shotgun, it's Lawrence. There's a short one taken by Ingram. Here now, 3rd and 5. Working out of the gun, it's Lawrence. He'll let this one go. Deep for Thomas. And he's going to be taken down right at the 25-yard line.
Defensively, you put so much effort about defending the middle of the field. You know that's the valuable real estate every offense is looking to attack. But what does that do, Mike? It makes you a little susceptible to the throws outside the numbers, and it leads to a chunk play.
A carry here for ETN. And he'll work forward for about 4. It's 2nd down. To throw is Lawrence. This one is caught by Kirk. Well, he's brought down. That pass is going to pick up 4. And bring up 3rd down. Oh, there's movement up front. That's going to make this third down a lot tougher. So, from third and two, back him up to third and seven. Throwing is Lawrence. And this ball incomplete on third down.
Little miscommunication there. Now brings up third down. It just doesn't appear that the quarterback and the wide receiver were on the same page on that last pass.
Cam Little for this field goal attempt. This one from 39 yards out. He is 2 for 2. That kick is good. And the Jaguars will extend their lead. The kickoff team is out on the field, and we're back to it as the kick's away. He'll start at the 4. And he'll work this one past the 25 to right about the 28-yard line. The visitors' offense getting things in order as they trot out for this next possession. They'll try to establish some tempo as they start this one with 1st and 10. They run it straight ahead with Pollard. And he'll take this forward for about 3. It's 2nd down. Now they'll set up to throw. He'll look middle here, caught by Boyd. They'll look to pick this up, 3rd and a yard. Putting the tight end in motion. They'll try and run for the 1st down with Pollard. And he's going to be brought down here on what will turn out to be the final play of the 3rd quarter. The Titans punting unit comes out to the field. Take it in, back at his own 12. And some nifty running on the return. Picked up some good yardage before he was taken down. The home team's offense make their way out to take over once more. They built a nice lead for themselves here. They'll try to add to that, beginning with 1st down. Lawrence. He's going to keep it himself. And he slides and covers up at the end, avoids the hit, and picked up decent yardage along the way.
These plays just kill you on defense. The pressure's good, but you have to contain them. Quarterback does a nice job of escaping the pocket, turns into a runner, scrambles for positive yardage.
In the pistol, here's Lawrence. Oh, and this one's going to wind up incomplete. That's one you'd think he'd be able to corral. But he can't find the handle, and it's going to lead to a 3rd down.
As you can probably imagine, Mike, this one really burns me. I mean, man, I wish my fellow tight ends catch every ball the entire game, but to be this open and not come down with it, I'm going to have to set a reminder. Next year at TEU, we're going to have to bring out some jugs machines.
And that is incomplete.
When you get the ball in this situation, what you're looking to do is not only end the drive with a touchdown to put the game away, but you'd love to chew up some clock. So with that incomplete pass now likely putting an end to this series, That's a big opportunity for them to try to close this game out.
Jaguars ready to punt this one away. As they try to play the field position game here, protecting a fourth quarter lead. Now a fair catch, and he'll take it at about the 24-yard line. The visitors' offense makes their way back out to the field for their next possession. They'll do so with first and 10. On play action, he'll set up to throw. He'll look deep, left sideline. And that ball led him too far, maybe too wide. Out of bounds, incomplete.
I think the biggest issue and why they find themselves trailing in this game, Mike, has really just been the ups and downs of this passing game. At sometimes, he's highly accurate and efficient. But at others, he just misses too many easy throws. Question is, are they going to be able to overcome this quarterback inconsistency and pull this game out?
He'll look for Pollard out of the backfield. He'll get about six before he's taken down. Here's a third down and four. Contact up front. Did they get one of the defenders to jump? So, from the 36, it is first and 10. Now, Rudolph. A throw right side, taken in by Boyd. And they'll get about half of what they needed. It's a pickup of five and sets up second and five. Throwing, Rudolph. It is caught. It is Westbrook-Ikhine. And they'll get him down after a gain of five, but that is enough for a first down.
Things certainly look a little improbable right now, Mike, but I wouldn't say impossible. I think they've got to capitalize on this possession to pick up some points. Every single possession right now is priceless. Points, possessions, and then they got to get some defensive stops.
They'll come up here on second down and five. Back to throw is Rudolph. And he got rid of that one quickly before the receiver even knew what was going on. That's incomplete.
They're lucky to have avoided this mistake here, Mike. In the fourth quarter, with possessions running out, that would have been a critical backbreaking play in this game. And they're going to have second life now after that defender drops the ball. And let's see if they can take advantage of it.
He'll get this into the hands of Ridley, complete. 15-yard pickup there. First down for Tennessee.
Okay, so now you pick up that first down, Mike, but now there needs to be a sense of urgency. You know you need to score twice. So this one, ideally for the offense, results in a touchdown. But either way, this first score of the two needed needs to be fast because you need every possession you can here late in the fourth quarter.
And he'll work forward for about three. It's second down. The motion man is Boyd. They fake the jet sweep and give it up the middle. Only a couple on that one. It'll set up third down. And this defense holds its ground. They stop him for no gain. And fourth down's coming up.
Great job here by this linebacker, Mike. There was no reading and reacting. From the snap, he was attacking. Meets the ball carrier right at the line of scrimmage. No gain.
Nick Folk now on with the field goal unit. This will be a 46-yard attempt. 3 for 3 in the game, as this one is also good. And the Titans will cut into that lead. Both teams ready to go once more as the kick's away. Washington now to return it. He'll work his way across the 25-yard line. The Jags offense getting set to get back to work. Their lead is 10. They go back to work, trying to add to it. It begins with first down. Drive begins with a carry from Etienne, and they'll mark him down just shy of the 40.
Two possession lead, fourth quarter. This is the time, Mike, when you really can rely heavily on your run game. Everybody in the stadium knows you're going to run it, including the defense. They just can't come up with an answer to stopping it.
So from the 39, they come up on first and 10. Back to throw, Lawrence. That's caught left side by Ingram. And he's close to a first down. It's a gain of 9. Nice pitch and catch on first down. Davis going in motion. Second down, Lawrence. Open man is Davis. And they're going to work this down inside the 45.
An interesting decision there by the play caller to put this ball in the air. Mike, you're up by 2 scores. Traditional wisdom says, hey, we're up by 2 scores late in the fourth quarter. We've got to keep this clock moving. You don't want to risk an incompletion. Now, they convert. They're able to secure the catch and pick up a fresh set of downs. That's going to enable them to continue to burn more clock. And without a stop, their opponent's not going to get the ball back.
Lawrence gives this one to Etienne. And they bring him down inside the 25-yard line.
So when you're evaluating the impact of a team's run game, Mike, I think it's important at the end of the game to look back and say, okay, how many yards did they run for? But more importantly, when did those yards come? Did I run for those yards in the fourth quarter, which typically means I had the lead? That's the sign of a successful run game, as opposed to getting a lot of meaningless yards early in the game.
Not much there, maybe a yard. They go play action for Lawrence. That is caught at the 3. And he's in! Ingram, touchdown Jaguars. Greg, that's one of those scores where it's not completely over, but it's getting to be about that time.
Yeah, Mike, I just think they're entering miracle stage right now, and I just don't think there's any coming back from this deficit.
Extra point by Little is good, and the Jaguars will open it up even further here in this fourth quarter. The kickoff team is out on the field, and we're back to it as the kick's away. Spears now to return it. He'll get this up to the 28-yard line. Nice place for the drive to start. The Titans offense back onto the field for their next possession. The deficit is 17, so they got to start cutting into it soon. See if it starts here. First and 10. Rudolph. He's going to get it to Okonkwo. It'll be taken down rather swiftly after a gain of just 3.
It's not the big play they were hoping for, but first down efficiency, staying ahead of the chains, is what every offense is trying to find, and it brings up a manageable second down.
To throw is Rudolph. Connecting with his tight end, Okonkwo. They'll empty out the backfield as they come up for 3rd and 1 yard. Here's Rudolph. He's gonna look for the home run ball. That is brought in. And they bring him down there, but it is inside the 10. It is gonna be 1st and goal.
How impressive was this, Mike? I mean, every week, yes, we see running backs used in the passing game. Check down, screens out of the backfield, typically underneath short throws that allow them to then run after the catch.
And he's in. Calvin Ridley, touchdown Titans. Well, Greg, the light's still on way down at the end of the tunnel here. They are climbing back into this one with that touchdown here in the 4th quarter.
And they have a tall task ahead of them, Mike, but they have a chance. I mean, we've seen stranger things happen. They got a 2-possession game here late. They're going to need a couple stops, and they're going to need a couple things to bounce their way.
Even with 3 timeouts plus the 2-minute warning, they're going to try an onside kick. The kickoff unit is out there, and they'll send this one away. The home team's offense ready to get back to work. They start with the lead and the football, and they do so with tremendous field position. It's 1st and 10. They'll start this one with a 3 tight end look. The handoff, it's ETN. A modest gain, maybe 2 yards. It's 2nd down. Lawrence will give it to Bigsby. And he'll get this ahead. Gain of about 4. And it leads to 3rd down. Going to try to pick up the 1st down with his own read. And he's going to be taken down, and that will take us to the 2-minute warning. It's a three tight end look as they have it first and 10. Up the middle, here's Etienne. Trying to find some place to go, but nothing developing. Tackled behind the line. It's a loss of one. Lost one on the last play, so now it's second and 11. Once again, it's Etienne. And he's going to be swallowed up again. Back-to-back runs, back-to-back losses. Now it is third down. They'll run it once more with Etienne. Cam Little for this field goal attempt. This from 45 yards away. Three for three in the game as this one is also good. And the Jaguars add on to their lead. Both teams ready to go once more. As the kick's away. Spears now to return it. And they'll bring him down just shy of the 30-yard line. The Titans offense ready to get back at it. They'll come up for first and 10. They'll drop to throw. His throw on first down is going to be incomplete.
Just didn't quite get enough into that ball. You see sometimes the pressure, the rush, force a quarterback to throw the ball off his back foot. And I think there was a little bit of that here at play. You have to be willing to step up, even in the face of pressure, and get enough behind that ball to put that one a little bit more on the money.
Rudolph looking to throw. He'll check this down to the running back. 18 yards on the catch and run will move the chains.
This guy's really starting to roll now. I mean, his involvement in the passing game just continues to pick up. And until the defense identifies him as a pass threat, I expect this quarterback to keep looking his way.
He'll drop to throw. Down the field, he's got his tight end Okonkwo. And this is going to be a touchdown. Hold everything. They are not done yet. What a luxury to have in an offense, a tight end who can take it down the field like that and take it the distance. Shades of Greg Olsen back in the day.
Well, I appreciate that, Mike, but I think it's clear by now that we all know what's the most impactful position on offense. It's the tight end. And when you have a guy like this who can not only make those difficult catches underneath, but who can get down the field for these big plays, man, you got yourselves a weapon.
A one-score game late, and you figure they got to have this one as they'll try an onside kick.
That was their last shot. They've got no timeouts left. Now the offense could just simply come take the field. Best play in football, Mike. Victory formation, take a couple knees, get on with the win.
Here's first and 10. victory formation here as he's down to a knee. So shouts at Duval in Duval County, Florida. It is a win for the Jaguars. This was a game where both offenses were up and down the field, marching the ball at will, matching each other point for point. But in the end, got a few more defensive stops than their opponents did. And that was the difference in this one. And that'll do it for my partner, Greg Olson, for our entire presentation. NFL on EA Sports. The Jaguars are the winners here at home as we say so long from Jacksonville.